What do laundromats and libraries have in common? Well, we find that out in our article this month, our lifestyle article. I had never thought of this or heard of this, Pauline, but apparently in the United States, there are some places where you can go wash your clothes and read a book at the same time. Perfect.
I think it's so brilliant. I love whoever thought of this. What a creative, innovative response to kind of a problem. Yeah, sitting in a laundromat is boring. And of course, now everybody has their phones, but to see that as a possibility, a potential for learning and encouraging people to read and making that space more of an engaging space of like positivity as opposed to just like this, ugh, you have to get your laundry done and maybe feeling like it's a stigma of poverty having to go and do the laundry. Now it's like this place for all this learning and fun. I don't know, because when I think libraries, I have a much different like emotional response to it too, and I love bringing those two together. I just think it's so great.
Yeah, and it's something good for the kids to do, better than just watching their tablet, right? Or something like that. They can read something while their mom or dad maybe is doing the laundry. So I think it's excellent. But what about you? When you were a kid, Pauline, what helped you to start enjoy reading?
Well, the biggest thing was that my family did not have a TV.
Oh,
We,
there you go.
my family was very intentional about not having a TV in our house because they wanted us to find other healthier ways to engage with the world and entertain ourselves. And so I read a ton when I was younger. I read a lot more than I read now. And it made a big difference in my studies. And I'm just really grateful for the intentionality my parents put into that. Oh, I would say the other thing is my mom read to us every night growing up, all the way up until I was in high school because I still had younger siblings. She read to us every night. So she also modeled a love for
Yes.
reading.
Awesome. And it's really important to start at a young age, right? To enjoy that at a really young age. And so that's something to think about with our kids as well. Well, moving on, do you think the importance of cleaning various filters in your home, is that something that you think about, right? I don't think about that a lot. I was just doing that the other day, taking out the filters and the AC and so forth. But what about you? Do you think about this much or do that?
The only reason I think about it is because my husband is very sensitive to air quality, so he's and he also used to run a hotel. So he has the double, both of those things making him very aware of cleanliness issues, especially air quality. So thankfully, I have him to do it and also to make me aware of it. Otherwise, knowing my personality, I would be terrible about it. I'm
Right.
sure I would be living in this like toxic environment if it
Well,
was
you
not
can't
for
see
him.
them. They're hidden, right? So you have to
I
really think about that, but apparently it's important. So think about your filters. Maybe they you can go and wash them this afternoon or whenever you're watching this tomorrow. Something good to do. I did it just the other day. It only took a few minutes, right?
Yeah,
So
and it really can make a huge difference. We notice a big difference in my
yeah.
husband's health when we do it.
There we go. All right, so check that out, and we thank you for joining us for another segment of Insights. Pauline, thank you for joining us as well,
You're
and we'll
welcome.
see you all next time.